Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're doing a get it all done style video, cleaning out the kids' room and organizing those toys before Christmas hits this week, because we all know that we all need to do this before the new influx of toys come in. And then also I am repping some Christmas gifts and sharing a skincare Target haul. So stay tuned for all of the motivation and inspiration in today's video. Alright, like I said, today I'm doing a get it all done style video. Now I caught this on camera, but you see how the lights turn out. Okay, the power went out, I blew a fuse. So this morning in particular was just a morning, oh my goodness. And I know that all of us mamas go through the same thing. I share a lot of this behind the scenes stuff over on my Instagram. If you guys wanna follow me over on Instagram, you get to see some of the behind the scenes and day in the life stuff from day to day. But Riker had like gotten into the fish tank this morning, dumped out an entire thing of fish food, and I went to go vacuum it up and I blew a fuse and I lost it. I was just laughing because it's such like a typical mom thing. It's like one thing after another. So anyways, if you guys want to follow along on all of the behind the scenes stuff, you can head over to my Instagram and watch my stories because I upload there on a daily basis. But anyway, all right, so getting into the kids' toys. Now I like to use organizational bins underneath Kaya's bed for Barbies, baby dolls, and dollhouse things. And then I have like bins over by their dresser in the corner, and I use the top bin for dress up and the bottom is more so for like Riker's toys. And then I have a couple of like buckets at the end of Kaya's bed for stuffed animals. And then what I'm doing here is I'm organizing out the books. There is a bookshelf here. It's, you can't tell in the footage, like the camera cut it off, but there is a bookcase over there with a TV on top of it. Recently set up some like new rules with the TV in their room because not all kids get to have a TV in their room. So we started like at night, you know, they really like to fall asleep to TV shows, which we know is not the greatest. Mike and I are so guilty of this as well. I'm just being super raw and honest here. We've always fallen asleep to a TV, but Mike and I like to fall asleep to Blue Planet. So we just recently switched the kids over to this as well. And we set a 30-minute sleep timer so that as soon as they're asleep, the TV is off. And I don't feel like Planet Earth is the worst thing in the world that they could listen to. I feel like it's about the same as an audiobook, etc. Or some kind of like noise machine, but definitely that like calming David Attenborough, guys. I mean, seriously, like the voice of David Attenborough will just soothe you right to sleep. So anyways, that is what we've been doing for the kids lately. Riker has definitely entered the terrible two stage. So anything I can do to soothe and calm him, I will definitely give it a shot. But here I just like pile up all the toys and I organize them into the categories. This way it's easier for Kaya to find her toys. Now usually she does clean her own room, but for the purpose of this video and for the purpose of my OCD, I wanted to organize it out before the Christmas toys came in, because like I said, it just gets so crazy and I like to have everything organized out, ready to go before the new toys come in. Okay, so I've like clearly been neglecting everything, but I told you guys in my last video where I showed my laundry closet that I do laundry like every week, week and a half, and that is very true to character for me. It's been about a week since I recorded that video for you guys, so I'm just cleaning everything out, reorganizing again, getting my bearings as far as like what I need to get done as far as laundry, and sorting everything out. So I just wanted to pop in, tell you guys true to form, here I am a week later doing laundry again. I do like run the loads through so we have clean laundry. I just don't put the clothes away until like a week later. I don't know. It's just a vicious cycle. I don't know why I do this to myself, but anyways, this is my laundry routine. All right, so I am finishing up the wrapping of presents for this year. I have said this a million times, but I always start early and I end late. I just like take my time finding the presents. Usually I start with the kids and I'll start in early November and like fill up my carts and just, I know exactly what I'm getting the kids. Now, as far as the rest of my family, I really pay attention to the things that they are like wanting or needing this time of year. So that is why I take my time. My little sister was honestly the hardest this year. I'm not going to tell you what I got her just because I don't want to spoil it for her. She watches my videos. So anyway, I just take my time getting everything like perfect. And I really, really love giving gifts. Reason for the season is definitely not gifts, but I love showing my family how much I love them by getting them super awesome gifts, like really well thought out gifts. I think is just like one of my love languages for my family members. I love getting them exactly what they're wanting or needing. So anyways, I'm finishing up in this part of the video some Christmas gift wrapping. It's all over the place with my gift wrap this year. I just kept finding super cute ones to, like at every store that I went to. So this one in particular is from Home Goods and was the nicest quality wrapping paper that I picked up this year. It's like really thick and I found it at Home Goods for like $6.99. So, and it came with like a ton of wrapping paper, but anyways, I'm going to let you guys enjoy the wrapping paper and Riker trying to destroy it as I'm working on it. But leave it in the comments down below. What was your favorite wrapping paper this year? Where did you guys find it from? I'm such like a gift wrapping freak. I love finding like super cute wrapping paper. I don't know what it is, but I just love wrapping gifts. Okay, so the last thing I want to share with you is just a quick Target haul. Mike is upstairs putting Riker to bed after zero napping today, so that is why. And Kai needs to go potty. Okay, sounds good. All right, so I saw these at Target. These were 2 for $7. I think they're like Qua keto. Anyway, or Koya. I don't really know. Anyways, I picked up two of these and I got, oh my goodness, if you could just like focus. There we go. This one is the cake batter one. It's dairy free and it has 9 grams of MCT oil, 0 added sugar, and it's 2 net carbs. And I think they're just like protein type shakes. So I got one of those. And then I got one of these and this is the chocolate brownie. And same thing, it only has 2 grams of net carbs, no added sugar, it's plant powered, and it is dairy free. So anyway, they just look like kind of like protein shakes. They have, let's see, what kind of protein do they have? 12 grams of protein per serving, and that is for one serving, it's like one whole bottle. So anyway, it's a plant-based keto shake is what it says. I might even try to like add a little bit of ice to it and see what I think, because this would be like really yummy to have as a lunch if I'm just like not super hungry. And then I picked up, poor Riker, he's not having it. I picked up the Love Beauty and Planet Turmeric and Tonka Essence. I heard that this is kind of like a dupe like from TikTok for the Brazilian Bum Bum brand, and I love that brand. It smells so good. Got this for the mountain of a zit that is on my face. I just use pure salicylic acid acne treatment. Hang on, I'm trying to show them, Kai. And then I picked up this just in like a sample size. It was like $8 for the trial size, which I honestly think is kind of expensive, but the bigger version I believe is like $22.99. And this is the Hydro Boost. I use a water gel based facial moisturizer all the time. Picked up. Okay, hang on, Kai, just wait till I'm done. And then this is the, is it Noon? Nun? I'm so like bad at pronouncing some of these crazy names. But this is just like Liquid IV. They were out of the kind that we liked in Liquid IV. So I just got this one, and it's the strawberry lemonade. We like the strawberry Liquid IV. Grabbed Mike his deodorant, and that is this stuff. Grabbed some glycolic acid. This is $15 for this tiny little thing. The big one was $30, but I really like having like chemical exfoliant toner, and use instead of using like an abrasive exfoliant on my face, like St. Ives is a no-no. So I highly recommend this stuff. And then I don't know if I showed you guys this, but this is just Kaya's like scrunchies. And then I just got like a bubbly because I was super thirsty. And then I picked up some Oreos and cream cheese and some like white chocolate so we can make Oreo balls. So we will be making that tomorrow, and I will include our recipe in Monday's video. No, we cannot have any Oreos right now because we're gonna save these for the recipe. Okay, anyway, this is my little Target haul of like beauty goods, I guess you could call them. But yeah, these are highly recommend. Okay guys, the last thing I want to talk about in this video is some weight loss and keto stuff, just because I've been getting a lot of questions on my weight loss and keto. A lot of you want to have like a cheat sheet as far as keto, and I will put something together for you guys to be ready for the week after Christmas, so that if your New Year's goal is to lose some weight, like it is mine, I want to continue to lose weight, I will provide you with some of the tools that I've been using to lose weight, and I'll also share with you some good people to follow on YouTube, etc. If you want to be motivated in the keto lifestyle. So again, I intermittent fast every single day until about noon. That's my goal. Sometimes I only make it till 11. Sometimes I can make it till like 2 or 3. It really just depends on how hungry I am. Thank you, buddy, that's so nice. So anyways, I started keto the week before, you wanna sit in that chair? Good job. I started keto the week before Thanksgiving, and I've lost 20 pounds since then, and I've also had cheat days. I actually took 4 days off for Thanksgiving break, and even though I was having cheat days, I still counted my calories and I still tried to intermittent fast until noon every single day. So even though I was breaking like my keto eating way of life, like way of eating for like whatever, I still kept track of like the food I was eating in regards to just like calories to make sure I wasn't overeating on my calories. So that is how I manage it with cheat days. Now I've probably had 2 cheat days since then. I had 1 cheat day last weekend, and then I had only a cheat meal the weekend before. And now this weekend, I haven't really had any cheats per se. The only thing that I like kind of cheated on is this morning I had a quarter cup of hash browns, and now the rest of the day I just have to make sure that I am careful with my carbs. So with that being said, my carbohydrate count, even like I pre-calced it out on my Fitness Pal for dinner, is still only gonna be like 27 net carbs or 26 net carbs for the day or something like that. And it is 3 o'clock right now. I'm having a late lunch. I had like I scrambled myself up some eggs this morning and I did not finish them. Before I went to my facial appointment, which I just got a facial today, my cheeks are super red because I was just sitting in my super hot car. But anyway, for lunch today, just to give you guys an idea, I had to waste a little bit of time in the vehicle because Riker was napping. I went to go make a delivery for a customer for M&M, and Riker fell asleep, which is awesome because he's not been napping lately and he's been going to bed really late. So I just let him sleep and I like swung by Subway because it was on my way home and I got Mike like food. And Kaya is with her auntie today making cookies. So I just had Riker with me. Anyway, I let him nap, swung by Subway, got Mike his like regular foot long. And what I will do is I'll order the chopped salad. Now you can get any of their like sandwiches in a chopped salad. I like to get the spicy Italian one and I'll get like everything except for the jalapenos and banana peppers, unless I love jalapenos and banana peppers, but sometimes with the Southwest sauce, I get really bad heartburn, so I just have to like be careful. And then for my sauce on top, I'll get the Southwest and a little bit of mayo to kick up the fat. And the calories on that, I believe, were around like 630 calories. And then for dinner tonight, I'm having pork chops with a little tiny bit of cream of mushroom on top because my mother-in-law is making dinner. So that is what she is making and I will have a little bit of that. And then I'll probably have, it's Saturday night, so I'll probably have like one of my go-to like adult drinks is like like the hard seltzers. I really like those. But I try not to have drinks when I'm on keto a ton. But if I'm going to, I'll have like a Truly, or like some kind of hard seltzer, or press. And then I will have like vodka sodas as well, in case you guys are wondering. And I am like, I really love wine, but the carb count on the wine is just so much. So anyways, okay, so there are some tips and tricks for you guys. I will have an entire breakdown for you in my video that is coming up the last week of December, and I'll go through all of my keto tips and tricks and update you on my weight loss as of that point. After Christmas break, I usually gain like a few pounds back every single time I have like a cheat day or water weight, like just the water weight like packs on. So right now I am 20 pounds down. I will update you in about 2 weeks to let you know where I am at weight loss wise with keto and give you a breakdown of like basically just like a cheat sheet, okay? All right, I will see you on Monday for a day in the life, okay? Bye guys.